Okay, students, from the previous part we have done the various types of that relationship between time period and frequency. Now the next topic is measurement of time period of a simple pendulum. Now what we have done, we have seen this pendulum, this is the length and this is the bob. Now how much time it takes in covering the one oscillation, so we have to discuss with this. Now here is certain things, we have length, we have time period. Now how the length affects the time period of the oscillation, in this topic we will discuss it. As we know that it is true, when the bob moves it comes in the to and fro motion from its mean position. Now the time period for, we noted the time period, the time t for 20 complete oscillation is measured with the help of stopwatch. What we have to take, we have to take stopwatch, and 20 complete oscillation is measured. Now suppose in this, see that this table, in this length is 25, time for 20 oscillation is 20, and time period capital T we have to compare that in total time taken in 20 oscillations upon 20, then we have the answer 1. Clear? In the same way we have to go with the different types of values, and we have to calculate that how much that this time period is taken by the simple pendulum. Now with the following observation, what they have observed, that if the length of the pendulum is 4 times, the time period of the oscillation gets doubled. That is, now it takes twice the time for one complete complete to and fro motion. That means if you are increasing the length of the pendulum by 4 times, then its time period get doubled. Now there is a relation which we come with the help of this, that T is directly proportional, this is the sign of directly proportional, is root of length. T is directly proportional root of length, and it can also be written like this also, T square is directly proportional to L. Now with the help of this expression, they have plotted a graph. This graph is very important for exam, that here they have plotted T square, and here it is length of the, on Y axis T square, on X axis length of the pendulum. When length is L1, then T1 square is A. When length is L2, then T2 square is B. Now with the help of this, they have calculated the slope of this line. This line indicates the relationship between L means length of the that pendulum, and T is time period. Now here they have calculated the slope. Slope equals to PR upon QR. What is PR? See in this graph, P, that they, here it is P and R and QR. That means P and R upon QR. Now if you want to calculate PR, that means T1 square minus T2 square. See here it is T1 square minus T2 square and QR. If you want to calculate QR, then this is the longer one, L1 minus L2. So slope can be calculated by T1 square minus T2 square upon L1 minus L2. Now see why these relations are given, although it is experimental part of the simple pendulum, but we have to know about this graph, these relations, for exam point of view. Now see, with the help of this, what they have during the experiment, what they found, this slope is found to be constant at a place is equal to 4 pi square upon g. At a certain place it comes to be constant, and that value is given by 4 pi square upon g, where g is acceleration due to gravity. Now where g is acceleration due to gravity, thus g can be determined at a place from these measurements by using the following relation. G is given by 4 pi square upon slope of t square versus L. Learn this relation. Now here the next point is, we have done the different type of concepts of simple pendulum, how the factors important for exams, how the factors will affect. First, time period of the oscillation is directly proportional to the square root of the effective length. This one time period is directly proportional to the square root of the effective length. This is the first factor. Now the second factor is, the time period of the oscillation is inversely proportional to the square root of acceleration due to gravity. How? If for this reason pendulum clock goes slow when it is taken on mountain or to mines due to decrease in value of g. If the value of g decreases, then t decreases. Keep in mind this. These factors are very important for exams. One of the important, very important this, that time period of the oscillation does not depend on the mass or material of the suspended bob. Next, the time period of the oscillation does not depend on the extent of swing on either side. Clear? Now, expression for the time period of simple pendulum. Now, here it is, t equals to 2 pi, learn this relation, root of L upon g, where L is the effective length of the pendulum, g is acceleration due to gravity. Now, see, this is general relation with the help of, it can be asked in exam, that second pendulum, the pendulum of a clock when we use to note time in our house. In a second's pendulum, it takes 1 second to move from one extreme to the other extreme. Clear? This is the second pendulum in which the time taken by the pendulum is 1 second when it completes one oscillation. Clear? Now, here the chapter is over. Today I am going to tell you the questions which you have to do in your classwork copy. Tomorrow I am going to give you the video of next chapter. Before that, you have to complete the questions of 1A, 1B and 1C. 1A, I have already told you. 1B and 1C, today I am going to tell you how you have to do, which questions you have to do in classwork copy. And be careful, you have to make register for that physics. Thank you.